Hi, I'm Rob Powers from Clever Machine. We build our app Scenechronize using the Google Web Toolkit. Scenechronize is an application designed for a producing team to make a movie or television program. Let me show you the application.
Scenechronize is an application that's based around a script for a movie or a television production. The user would first load in a PDF of their script, and we would parse it. We pull information about the scenes, the locations, and the speaking characters directly out of the script. As you can see on the display here, the script is shown on the left side, and the user can scroll through. As they scroll, the page updates to show the various information for the current scene. The user can also navigate using the pearls along the top by just clicking, and it will directly go to that scene, or also using the list box along the left side. Let's go take a look at a scene that has some information in it that would be typical in a production that's in progress. In this particular scene, you can see that on the right, there are a number of items that are described. These are the various pieces for that scene that are going to be needed when shooting occurs. These would include the characters with speaking parts, as well as non-speaking parts, extras, animals, picture vehicles, sound effects that needs to happen, set information, and the like. To add new items into the scene, you can either click on part of the UI on the right, or you can tag. And tagging is simply a selection in the script itself, telling it what item category you're including. In this case, we have a camera that's needed for scene 21, and we already have an existing camera in the system. So we can select the existing element, and it gets displayed right on the screen. For more information about any of the items, you can click on them. And it will show a list of what scenes that particular item is used in. In this case, we're looking at a character called David from this movie. He appears in 73 scenes, and there were a number of actors that were considered for the role. For the actors, you can click onto any of the options that were considered and see pictures as well as other biographical data. You can choose the appropriate actor that's actually going to be used in the movie on this screen. You can notice that as soon as you select one, if we switch tabs, it will be reflected immediately there. Any reporting that gets done on the project will include the latest update as soon as you enter it. Another use for our application is for scheduling a production. The tool that's used in the industry is something called a strip board, and what we have provided is an electronic version of that. It's basically a list of scenes, each one as a quote-unquote strip, that are broken down by shooting day. Our application uses a drag-and-drop interface that allows the user to pull one or more of these strips around the strip board as needed. As those changes happen, things like the number of pages that are being shot that day updates live. The rich interface that our app provides allows users to work in an environment that is comfortable to them while providing a lot of data in a small amount of screen real estate.
We chose to use GWT for our application because it allowed us to write in Java, which opened up the wide range of tools that are available for Java-based apps. This allowed us to maintain the app, refactor the code, and most importantly, debug it much more easily than if we'd been writing in JavaScript directly. We tried a few of the other JavaScript libraries available, and we found that our code was slower and more bug-prone than when we were using GWT. One of the other advantages of GWT is because it's multi-browser, supports multiple browsers, we're able to actually write our app so it looks the same and works the same across four major browser types. As far as the user's concerned, they don't know that there's a difference between them, but the code is obviously quite different because of the GWT compiler's output. We extended the GWT widget library so that we could use a custom MVC layer that we built, and this allowed us to minimize the amount of data that needed to be called into the client and simplified the client coding so that we were less prone to introducing bugs due to custom data request data requests that we would need to make. We utilized the plugin architecture of the GWT RPC layer to support the back end of that. So as a user needs data, we can pull it piecemeal, piece by piece from the server. And as they make changes to things, we can push the changes live back to the server. Overall, we've been very happy with our experience with GWT, and our app has been much better as a result.